So from the last video, we formed a concrete equation, which is the equation of gravity, and I'm going to use that now to show you something about astrology. So it turns out that the law of gravity exists between any two objects. It doesn't just have to be planets. So for example, if I'm standing here on the Earth, this is like me here, and let's say that the planet Neptune is way up here in outer space, I have all of the conditions met to calculate gravity. Like, I have a mass, and I happen to know that my mass is about 90 kilograms or so. Neptune has a mass. It's much, much larger than mine. I don't even know what it is offhand, but we could look it up. And, of course, no matter what, there's always going to be some distance between me and Neptune. So if I wanted to, I could calculate the gravitational force between me and Neptune using just the law of gravity. Let's say instead of M1, I'll call it my mass. Instead of M2, I'll call it the mass of Neptune. And of course, it'll be the distance between me and Neptune squared. All of this is possible. It would actually be true. Neptune, even as I'm speaking to you here, is exerting a gravitational force on me. There's no doubt about that. So here's the story that I would like to tell you then, which is takes a jab at astrology. Okay, so suppose then that I am being born, or someone is being born. I guess I'm already born. So let's just say someone's being born in a hospital, okay? So here's like a little crib right here that the little baby's in, and let's say that the baby is lying down in the crib here, and they're in the hospital, I don't know, getting ready to go home, and I guess there's some legs on the crib there, and we'll just say that they're in sort of the hospital room here, no big deal. And of course, Neptune is up here. Neptune's always up there. And so it would be true, once again, as I just said, that there is a mass of the baby right here. Let me do that maybe in a slightly different color here. There's going to be a mass of the baby and, of course, a mass of Neptune. And there is a distance between the baby and Neptune. And so it would be true, according to the law of gravity, that Neptune is exerting a force on the baby to the tune of G times mass of the baby times mass of Neptune over D squared. Okay? This is all true. But then I take pause for a minute here because this is sort of what physics says here, or astrophysics says. This is scientific. But then astrology is going to say that the baby is going to have some kind of lifestyle or some kind of mood or attitude or personality because they were born in the season of Neptune. And if you look up some astrology about Neptune, Neptune is the ruler of the seas, ruler of Pisces, you know, the fish constellation that I sort of brought up a few times. So it has this big meaning and that sort of thing. So I'm sort of on purposely here colliding two ideas in front of you here. I'm colliding the scientific idea of Neptune exerting a gravitational force on the baby, and I'm also colliding the idea of astrology, that the baby was born when Neptune was prominent in the sky, and Neptune has this big role of ruler of the seas and ruler of Pisces. Okay, and so my story is going to continue like this then. What also happened that day in the hospital is that there was a machine here. I don't know what it was. Maybe it was something like a ventilator that wasn't used for this baby, but was sort of left there by mistake. The person who was supposed to get it from the room and move it out that evening went out to a 7-Eleven and bought a lottery ticket and won a lot of money and just never returned to work. And the reason why I'm telling you this about the lottery here, because this was totally random, right? Like, supposedly, if the person lost the lottery, they would have come back to work and moved the ventilator. But they went out and something totally random happened to them. They won the lottery and even on top of that decided just not even to come into work the very next day. And so the issue I have with this, and this will be the setup for my jab here, is that, well, in this situation then, look, the ventilator has a mass, M sub ventilator. And the ventilator baby, they also have a distance between them, which is this line right here. So in the third case here, we have another issue at play here. There's a force of gravity between the ventilator. G times MV, the mass of the ventilator, times the mass of the baby, divided by their distance squared. So what I'm sort of doing here is I'm colliding three things for you here. the pull of Neptune, which I guess has something to do with astrology, but we also have the pull of this ventilator, which was supposed to be moved out of the room, but it wasn't because of some random occurrence that happened of the employee who was supposed to move it won the lottery. And so the ventilator is still in the room next to the baby. In the next video, I'll tell you what happens.